Hello everyone, my name is Andrea Mazza. Today I'm going to talk about the use of the distributed energy resources installed at distribution system level for making, for allowing the frequency regulation. Why this? Because Lucian explained in the previous presentation, up to now, let's say up to a few years ago, all the there was no problem regarding to energy distributed energy resources. Why? Because the share of these resources was low. Okay, so the entire chain for the frequency regulation was actually based on the rotating machines, synchronous generators that made their job, so making the system frequency constant and regulating it. But now the situation is changing due to the fact that the renewable energy resources, or better, the distributed energy resources there installed at the distribution system level is increasing. And so we have to maintain the capability of the system to regulate the frequency in spite of this increase of renewable energy sources. So this study was carried out by UCD, that is a partner of Reserve. You have here the reference, frequency control of distributed energy resources distribution networks. And the aim of the study that I'm presented here now is comparing three different strategies for doing what? This is the point. For creating the input signal that should be sent to the regulator installed in the power converters of the distributed energy resources, okay, for making this frequency regulation. It should be clear that every their plant has its own regulator, okay? So we are going to create with these three strategies, centralized, decentralized and average strategy, the input signal that is feeding the regulator of the DER, okay? So the first strategy is called centralized. We have only one measurement point, okay? We have a phase measurement unit, PMU, installed at the point of common coupling, PCC, between the transmission system and the distribution system, okay? In that case, we are getting the measurement and send the same signal, and this is a good point, the same signal to all the regulator in the different plants in the distribution system. However, we have only one measurement point, so we need redundancy. We cannot have only one measurement unit. We have more, at least two, okay, for having a backup in case of one of them is not working properly. The other, let's say, drawback lies in the communication delay that exists, okay, because I have to get this the measurement, I have to calculate what I need, and then send to every plant in the distribution system. The second strategy investigate here instead is the decentralized one. In this case, all the measurements are made locally, you see here. Every distributed energy resources has its own measurement in that point. In this case, what we have, of course, there is no communication delay, because I'm using the measurement that I'm doing exactly in that place. However, there is no coordination between the distributed energy resources installed in the distribution system, and the frequency estimation can be changed node by node due to the different properties of the network, okay? And in particular, due to the fact that the different tools for measuring the frequency, for estimating the frequency, as in any case, numerical issues to be solved, okay? Finally, the third and the last strategy is called average. strategy. In this case, we have that the frequency estimation is made locally in every point, then is sent to the data management system or distribution system, grid. And in this data management system is calculated the average of all the points. Then I have to send this average to the controller of every plant. Of course, we have as, let's say, positive aspects, the use of only one signal for all the sources, because I make the average and send back to them. The drawback is that the strategy is based on bidirectional communication, because I have to send before to the DMS and then back to the sources, so the delay should be higher, this is for sure, okay? Okay, here the case study. Okay, the case study is very simple, it's a proof of concept. It's not comparing, it's not possible to compare with the large systems that exist, but is useful for understanding what is happening. A small system means that you can go in detail about what is happening there. The transmission system is composed of 9 bus, very small, okay, it's a test system called WSCC. And it is composed of 3 traditional generators, rotating generators, okay? Then, at the node 8, that is this one, is in the equivalent load that before was existing in that point, has been substituted by a distribution system, okay? Distribution system that is operated at 38 kilovolt, okay? And has this kind of load. We see immediately that the power of the energy storage is much more higher than the load existing there. So there is a lot of capacity there, okay? The same regulator exists for all the distributed energy resources that in our case are 2 wind plant, 1 PV plant, and the energy storage system, okay? Which is the aim of this study? Well, verify 2 more aspects, 2 aspects in particular, the robustness of the strategies in case of communication delay, and this can affect 2 of our strategies, the centralized and the average, because we have to send, okay, some signals. The second one is understanding how much the strategies are robust against what? The loss of information. I can lose a point of measurement, okay? And so I can have an affection of my results. Due to the fact that we had already we pointed out that we have to have a redundancy for the centralized strategy, this kind of aspect has been investigated only for the decentralized and the average strategy, that are the ones that are, let's say, using the local measurements in the distribution system, okay? For doing this, has been simulated a contingency at the bus 7 here of the transmission system, okay? And the effect is cleared after 150 milliseconds by opening the proper lines, okay? Okay, here, results. Okay, these results are based on 2 main, let's say, 2 main aspects. The first is that these 2 figures are representing errors. Errors means that I have to compare something with my, let's say, reference value. What is the reference value? The reference value in our case is an ideal trajectory of the frequency that I have in the node 6, so the node of the common coupling between transmission and distribution network by using a mathematical framework called a frequency divider that I'm not explaining here is happening, let's say, appears in the literature recently, introduced by Professor Milano and Alvaro Ortega that are working in reserve. So you have to imagine that with a mathematical formulation, we are able to present to have the trajectory, the variation of the frequency in the node of the network based on different measurements. And this one is our ideal trajectory, okay? Then we are going to compare the trajectory obtained by using the three strategies by feeding the regulators with the different inputs as mentioned before, okay? So we have this idea and the, let's say, real that are coming from the use of the strategies compared. This comparison provides this error, okay? This error is, let's say, is presented without delay communication. So is the error only because we are not, let's say, using the ideal frequency. What we can see is for sure that the centralized control is the one that is working better. Why this? Well, this kind of idea is it's true because we are using a measurement for the centralized point that is here at the node D1, that is the closest to the transmission system. So the robustness of this this measurement due to the fact that it's so much close to the transmission system is more guaranteed than other measurements. The decentralized instead, that is using different measurements widespread distribution system, is having the worst performance. Why this? Because I don't know the point is that the estimation of the frequency in points far from the transmission system can be affected by errors, numerical, noise, and whatever. So this kind of results is what we expected is that it is that the decentralized without a proper control can have this kind of drawback. The average is in the middle, okay? Because somehow is using some frequency estimation close to the transmission system, some frequency estimation that are not good, and these two are averaged. So the results are in the middle. However, if we are going to insert a communication delay, the things change, okay? The centralized still is maintaining very good performance, okay? You can see these peaks, even if the two scales are different, are quite similar. However, the average is becoming worse. About this, why? Because there is this the communication delay is affecting the performance of the strategy. The idea is okay, but what's happening if this average is increasing? Because that one was 20 milliseconds of delay. Well, with 35 milliseconds for the average and 55 milliseconds for the centralized, we see that. The average, for sure, has the worst condition due to these delays. But also the centralized, in the centralized happens this high frequency variation, okay? Due to this delay, because you send a command that is not refreshed, and is not updated enough for making the proper regulation. And this one, up to now, we investigated the delay of the communication. But now, we have to investigate what happens if I'm losing a point of measurement. It's happening this, that in case of this kind of representation, put together two different aspects that I would like to point out. That the decentralized is worsening, but now the average is better. Why this? Well, if you read the paper, but I can explain to you very, very shortly, the point that the hypothesis of the author was that the measurement lost was the worst one, was the point in which the estimation of the frequency was the worst, okay? So if you are deleting the worst measurement in the average, you are improving the performance of the average control, right? Because you are deleting the source of error, the major source of error of the strategy. Instead, for the decentralized, due to these local measurements and based on the local measurement, the loss of one point, in any case, provide a worsening of the conditions, okay? And the worsening of the results, okay? Which are the conclusions and more, which is the future work about this? Because this one was a proof of concept, clear. The different delays were investigated, different delays and the loss of at least one point of measurement. From the results, we can say that the centralized and the average strategies in any case are good, have good performance, but strictly depending on the delay that exists in the communication. This one is the main point that you have to take into account. When you have only one source, let's say, it is necessary to consider very well the delay. Instead, the decentralized strategy, of course, is not affected by the delay because there is at least a delay from the measurement to the use of the measurement, but the loss of a frequency measurement can lead to worse performance, okay? Now, all this kind of stuff, how can be used in the future? No? Because this one is, first of all, was made offline simulation. So we are using the DOM software mentioned before for making this kind of, let's say, studies. The idea now is to validate and, let's say, compare the use of real-time simulation, okay, with offline simulation, with two purposes. Understanding the phenomena that are under these results by also increasing the size of the system in case, but also, and especially, I would like to say, investigating how we can use properly this tool that is a real-time simulation for this kind of studies. Because imagine that maybe you can insert an algorithm in the loop, for example, a real PMU. For example, all this kind of stuff. So the list of the bunch list of the to-do list is based, first of all, replicate the same results with the same scenarios in the real-time simulator here in Athen, okay, where both the transmission distribution system are simulated on the same platform. This simulation in the same platform, in any case, should be taken into account the communication delay within simulators. Why? Because the second point is making a geographical distributed co-simulation between Aachen and Torino, and understanding, investigating how we can improve the performance of the simulations in terms of use of real-time simulator, and maybe enlarge, as I told before, the size of the network. With this, I conclude. So it was very, very short.